Welcome back at 4. The month of January is winding down, as we know, but just a few days left in it, and it's important to talk about Cervical Cancer Awareness Month. So the Associate Director for the Public Health Institute at Denver Health, Judy Schley, is joining us in studio to talk about this important issue, as well as the HPV vaccine. So Judy, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Let's get right into it, of course. How many women are actually diagnosed with cervical cancer a year?
So it's about 13,000 people a year in the United States, which is about 36 people a day.
Wow, those statistics are shocking. Can you discuss what causes this?
So predominantly it's caused by the human papillomavirus, or HPV, which actually comes through skin-to-skin contact from people. And it doesn't cause just cervical cancer, it also causes anal cancer, penile cancer, and ones that we're really worrying about is oral and throat cancers. So those are ones that are growing, particularly in men as well as women, we worry about the cervical cancer piece.
So let's talk about the HPV vaccine that we know of. How can people get aware of it? When do they get it?
So it's my favorite subject. I love this vaccine. This vaccine is available. It's recommended for people between 9 and up to the age of 26. The CDC recommends that people get it around 11 to 12, but can be as early as 9. If you start the vaccine series before you're 15, you only need 2 doses of it. If you start it after 15 or after, you need 3. So it's much better to only get 2 versus 3. And the reason we push it earlier is it's a prevention vaccine. So we want to give it before there's exposure, okay, and our immune system is much stronger in younger people than in older people.
So this is a prevention method, would you say?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's a cancer preventing vaccine, which for boys and girls, it works tremendously, and it eliminates risks almost completely if started in the young ages.
And can you talk about Colorado's numbers? Do you know how many cases we're seeing here in the state?
For cancer?
Yeah, for the HPV vaccine, the rate that adolescents are getting.
So in state data from Colorado Department of Public Health and Environment, they say that 37% of kids in June of 2022 completed the vaccine between the ages of 13 and 17. The Healthy People 2030 goal, which is part of the Health and Human Services for the country, wants us to be at 80%. Okay. So we're very vulnerable. Our kids are very vulnerable to getting cancer-associated problems because of HPV.
Yeah, so we've got a lot of work to do to try to make up that gap. And although it is Cervical Cancer Awareness Month in January, this conversation is going to continue.
Can I add one thing?
Sure.
So at Denver Health, we have clinics, family health clinics, school-based health centers, part of Denver Public Schools, and our immunization travel clinic, people can get it. These vaccines are covered by insurance, and if somebody doesn't have it, we have the Vaccine for Children program, which then allows kids under 18 to get the vaccine for free if they're uninsured or underinsured, and it's quite important.
That's great for parents to know out there. Dr. Judy Schley with Denver Health, thanks for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you.